we know that will be not long enough to see other types of displays, instead of commercial ones. To make sure that becomes reality, Chinese company TCL is working on displays that can be twisted and rolled. Actually, last year, TCL announced the launch of the 17-inch printed OLED scrolling display. This screen is only 0.08 inches thick. But that's not all, there is also a tiny AMOLED display, that measures 6.7 inches, but expands to 7.8 inches with a single tap. The production cost was reduced by 20%, and by 2025, the market for flexible displays should be 80% more profitable, according to the manufacturers. We really hope that these displays will be affordable in the near future, as they really have great potential. If you find this interesting, write us in the comments section what do you think about these displays. Earlier this year, a design studio from Italy showed the concept of an air yacht. What many of us dreamed about just got a better chance of becoming a reality. What exactly is it about? An accurate description could be airship, given that this yacht could fly and sail at sea. Air Yacht V2 comes with twin blimps filled with helium, solar panels throughout, and 8 counter-rotating electric motors of 950 horsepower each. It would be packed with light batteries too. According to the designer's calculations, the maximum speed of the V2 would be 115 miles per hour. Given the size of the V2, the maximum speed it could achieve on the water is 5.7 miles per hour. But speed is not the main feature of this yacht, and what it lacks in speed, it makes up for with luxury and comfort. We can only hope that one day, the V2 will grow from concept to reality. Although, the chances are slim. Imagine if we had flying hotels that never had to land on the ground? In the near future it could become a reality. The reason for this is the concept of a nuclear-powered aircraft, which would never have to land on the ground. Thanks to its nuclear engines, to be more precise, 20 of them, this plane could stay in the air permanently. It would also have the possibility to dock with other planes in the air, and it would have a capacity of up to 5,000 passengers. It would have cinemas, gyms, shopping malls, and pools, and it would provide all luxury that you would ever need. Those who would travel would have amazing views like spectacular sunrises and sunsets, and glorious night skies. The Aurora Borealis would be close and more extraordinary than ever. Turbulence would be eliminated by new technical advancements, giving passengers a completely smooth flight. Unfortunately, most experts say this beast of the skies defies all laws of aerodynamics, so it would never generate enough thrust to achieve or maintain flight. So what do you think about this concept? Would it ever be possible to see the light of the day, or it will stay as a concept and never go into production? And don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoy the content. From time to time we can hear about transparent phones. There are a few smartphone manufacturers that are working on some solutions for transparent phones. But as it seems right now, Samsung is the one who is putting the most effort into developing a smartphone with a transparent display. The company, according to the news report, is developing a new transparent phone design that will fundamentally alter how you interact with your phone. So how it would work? Each pixel of the screen will be displayed using transparent cells that allow light to pass through. Also, this technology is trying to be used in phones for the first time, so it is likely to be very different from all the advanced devices available so far. According to rumors, there will be no ports, and everything will be through wirelessly. It will be very difficult to say what would be phone specifications, but patents suggest that all bodies of handsets will not be transparent. Either way, every day we are closer to seeing this technology in everyday use. So what do you think? Are we far from this type of smartphone? Do you expect to see it in mass production very soon? Next on our list is a car that you probably heard of before. Mercedes-Benz developed the Vision AVTR in collaboration with the Avatar filmmakers to envision a sustainable future for the automobile. The Vision AVTR, which was inspired by Avatar, represents entirely new interactions between people, machines, and nature, offering a visionary outlook for automotive dreams to come. Brain-computer interfaces enable this new type of machine control, such as selecting a navigation destination by thought control, changing the interior lighting, or changing the radio station. Maybe they are not available in everyday life just right now, but they are, however, no longer science fiction. So what about technical specs? Battery capacity would be 110 kilowatt hours with graphene-based organic battery technology. An estimated range of 435 miles maybe is not a big surprise, but a full charge in less than 15 minutes for sure is. And what about power? Well, it has 469 horsepower with all-wheel drive with torque vectoring. I must say, that looking at this car, I think there is a bright future in the automobile industry. So what do you think? Would this type of car ever become a car for everyday use? With NASA planning to return humans to the moon later this decade, the race is on to develop concepts for a long-term lunar habitat. The latest vision for such a concept, called the Glass, has been shared by Japanese scientists. This massive 1,300-foot structure would rotate every 20 seconds to achieve normal gravity, and thus replicate Earth's living conditions. Achieved gravity of 1G would be at the point where the radius is largest. Thanks to the normal gravity, humans could have children with peace of mind, and maintain a body that can return to the Earth at any time by living in this facility. The transport system would be called the vehicle, and it will be used for connecting the glasses. However, it appears unlikely that the concept will be realized anytime soon. According to reports, the glass would take nearly 100 years to build, though a simplified version could be on the moon by 2050. Researchers also have long-term plans for their idea, hoping to build two separate facilities called Lunar Glass for the Moon, and Mars Glass for Mars. To connect Lunar Glass and Mars Glass, researchers proposed a high-speed transportation infrastructure that could connect Earth, Mars, and the Moon, called Hexagon Space Track, or Hexatrack. Hexatrack will need at least three stations, one on Mars Moon Phobos, one in Earth orbit, and one orbiting the Moon. Although this is far from realized, at least we know in what direction the future is going. Imagine if we would have cities with no roads, cars, or emissions? The cities that would run on 100% renewable energy, and 95% of the land will be preserved for nature. Well, in the near future all that would be possible, thanks to Saudi Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman, who proposed the line in 2021. The city is part of the Saudi Vision 2030 project, which Saudi Arabia claims will create 380,000 jobs and add $48 billion to the country's GDP. The line will be the first project in NEOM, a $500 billion city. The city's plans call for a population of 9 million people. Although it is only 200 meters wide, it is 170 kilometers or 110 miles long, and 500 meters above sea level. The city will be divided into nodes. All everyday services are intended to be within a 5-minute walk, in addition to high-speed rail, with an end-to-end transit of 20 minutes. The city will also be completely powered by renewable energy. The line will have three layers, one for people on the surface, one for infrastructure underneath, and another for transportation underground. The first residents were planned to move in during 2024, after initial earthwork began in October 2021. The first phase of the project is expected to be finished in 2030. Tell us what you think about the line. If you find it interesting, write it in the comments below and subscribe to our channel, it would mean a lot to us. As you see, the line was not the only future city. OCEANIX Busan is the first prototype of a resilient and sustainable floating community in the world. It intends to give groundbreaking technology to coastal areas, experiencing significant land limitations, caused by climatic changes. The task is enormous. 2 out of every 5 people on the planet live within 100 kilometers or about 62 miles of the coast, and 90% of the world's megacities are exposed to increasing sea levels. Flooding is damaging billions of dollars in infrastructure and displacing millions of climate refugees. Rapid urban population expansion is pushing people closer to the sea, raising housing costs to unaffordable levels, and forcing out the poorest families. Busan's unusual combination of old and modern will serve as a model for sustainable communities. It will extend this energy onto the waterfront, connecting the city and the coast. The city comprises 15.5 acres of interconnecting platforms that can house 12,000 people. With 30,000 to 40,000 square meters of mixed-use space per platform, each neighborhood is designed to fulfill a distinct purpose: residences, research hubs, or eco-friendly accommodation. And even with a starting population of 12,000 residents and visitors, it has the potential to grow to more than 100,000 people. The floating city prototype is supported by 6 integrated systems: closed-loop water systems, food, zero-waste and circular systems, net-zero energy, coastal habitat regeneration, and innovative mobility. In December 2021, OCEANIX co-founder told Business Insider that the project would cost around $200 million. However, based on the final design and OCEANIX's estimated project cost per square meter, which is $10,000, the price tag might be closer to $627 million. So what do you think about this type of city? Could more cities like this save us and help future generations?